Here's how to animate fire the quick and lazy way, a 2D stylized fire that I love and have done many variations of. And along the way, I want to introduce you to a few features in After Effects you might not know, and a key element that makes all fire animation extra fiery. So there are three main variations of this. Each works by having about four frames or so slightly different, but similar enough to the frames next to it. And there are a few ways we can do that. In After Effects, we could just draw four slightly different versions on new shape layers and play them in a sequence. We could also do the same, but all on one shape layer, keyframing the path property of the shape layer and just moving the points around a bit in each one. That way we get the animation between the keyframes, and we can make it faster or slower by spreading out those keyframes. And if you want to spread out keyframes while keeping the same proportions between them, we can just select them all, hold Alt or Option, and drag out the first or last keyframe. And to remove all the motion between the keyframes, select them, right click, and choose Toggle Hold Keyframes. So they're nice and frame by framey, just snapping towards each new drawing. Now we can also approach this a different way. Instead of drawing each path for the fire shapes, we can draw it once and then tweak it with an effect. So let's see what that looks like in a new comp with these two examples on the same shape layer. To add some slight random motion, our first instinct would be to add maybe the turbulent displace effect and animate its evolution to get it kind of wobbling all over the place. But no, that is going to ruin our lovely straight lines, which are integral to the aesthetic of this specific stylized fire. To get something similar that warps our animation subtly but keeps our lines straight and angular, we need to use another effect, but not the usual friendly effects we find over here. The sneaky are they even effects that we find way down here next to add in our shape layer contents. And we want to add here wiggle paths. And what wiggle paths does is randomly adjust the path of our shape, kind of like the roughen edges effect when it's left at its default setting. But we do have some more interesting options if we open up its properties. Let's just turn the size up a little bit so we can see a bit more clearer what's happening. And that is that it's created these extra jagged details and is moving them around, which is really just what we were doing earlier frame by frame. And it's currently jagged because the points are set to corner. We can change that to smooth if we want a more rounded look, but let's keep it to corner and turn the detail right down to zero so it's clearer exactly what it's doing. And it is moving each point that we've drawn on our shape layer randomly around, just like the wiggle expression. And if we increase the details just from 0 to 1, we can see that it adds one extra point in between where we've already drawn our points. So in between these two points that we have here, it has drawn an extra one in between. And if we increase it further, it adds more and more points. Let's take it back down to 1. And because this is adding extra points, you might want to keep your shape a little bit simpler than you intend, like I've done with the one on the right here, so it doesn't get too detailed and find more places where it really just looks bizarre. And it's also looking way too smooth here, so let's add the posterized time effect. And let's put that way down to 8 frames a second. Now it is looking a lot more hand animated. And we can also increase the wiggles per second up to 4 so it animates a bit faster. There, now wiggle path definitely has its limitations. I really think this works better the more simple and minimal your animation is, but it is great, especially for adding a stop motion cutout effect in particular. Like this fire we've got here on the right, slap a looping paper texture on that, some drop shadows, and baby, you've got a stew going. Now the wobbly curve style of fire I think is great, but I do prefer to do that in frame by frame drawing software. Again, drawing 4 or so duplicates of that one image with some slight differences, but this time making the curve of the fire move up the flame until it connects to the one above and you get a nice loop. Now you can mimic that with a tapered stroke in After Effects with some wave warps, but you do miss out on that roughness and chaos that you get from drawing it roughly frame by frame. Now the last element is something that will work in pretty much any style of fire, and that is to add these individual loose flames flying away. And we can do that easily enough in After Effects with just a shape layer. We're going to start by drawing a rough diamond shape. We'll call it flame because we always label our layers. And we are going to keyframe its shape path. Let's zoom in real close. And we're going to change it and keyframe it every second frame. So we would say it's animated on 2s. And I'm just going to double click it to select the path, drag it up a bit and make some slight adjustments with the pen tool. And we can flick back and forth to see the path it's going at. And we kind of want it to follow an S shape. So each frame, going to increase it in size and keep moving along that rough path. So its shape is slightly different each frame. And one main disadvantage After Effects has over frame by frame software is that it doesn't have onion skins, which are the faded views of frames before and after, so you can see better what you're animating as you draw. But we can actually fake that in After Effects, and that is by adding the effect CC wired time. And already we can see the frame beforehand, and we can adjust how many frames forward and back that we see. Let's set 4 frames backwards, maybe 2 frames ahead. And now we can really see when we get to drawing our next frame, whether it is in line with the frames beforehand, and we can make adjustments to it on the fly and even see the in-between frames and how they're going to look. So let's continue just making this a little bit smaller until it's gone completely. Now we can hide that CC wide time effect and see how our flame looks. There, that's looking pretty good. And this is playing at 24 frames per second. So to really put that on twos, we can select all of our keyframes and again, right click, toggle hold keyframes. So now we're just seeing the frames that we drew. Now let's crop this composition so it just fits our animation. And we do that by adjusting the region of interest down here. And then we can go up to composition, crop comp to region of interest there. And that blue background is just the background layer. So it is of course transparent. And then to a loop version of our fire, we can add that flame comp we just made, line up where the flame starts with the tip of one of the flames, and we've got a more interesting fire. And of course we can duplicate that flame layer and add it all around the place. Now these wispy flames even work on fire that's in motion, like in this example I use in one of the lessons for my Master Motion Design course. And is this shameless self-promotion? No, not for this amazing advanced animation course available at benmarriott.com. Couldn't be. But guess what? Next video, I will have a brand new beginner's course to plug, so look forward to that.